Okay, now we're gonna resume. Okay. Just making sure we're on live and in person. Okay, good. So now, what do we got going on?
I got lemon over here for our snow peas. Get rid of our trash.
Okay, we're gonna open swordfish. What are we gonna season it with? We're gonna do it basic. We're not gonna go crazy. We're gonna go just light. And I'm gonna change pans because I'm thinking I'm not gonna like that pan. No. We're gonna do a different pan. You can change, you know, when you cook them, you can change them up. Okay? Just want to be right. You know your kitchen, you know what you got. Do it. Swordfish in here. We're going to seal that nice. We're going to do our peas in here. A little mess over there that the wife's going to have to clean later. But don't tell her that, okay? So we're going to start up here. What are we going to cook first? Well, your rice is going to be 10 minutes. Your vegetables are going to take 5 minutes, 8 minutes. Our swordfish is going to take probably about 8 minutes. So, come over to the sink. Swordfish in here. Now, we bought frozen swordfish. Okay, I know, oh my God, yeah, why did I buy frozen? You're absolutely right. If you can buy fresh, buy fresh. But you know what? We go shopping one day a week. Frozen is just as good if you buy good quality. Again, good quality. Okay? Ready to whip it off. Okay? Now pat all your swordfish or all your fish dry. Okay? All your swordfish should be dry. Because if you don't, then all your flavor just gets wiped away. Flavor needs to go into the fish or the product, not your pan or your trash. Okay, so. Okay. Basic today. Salt. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to get a plate. Swordfish on the plate, and we're going to add our seasoning into the bowl. I like olive oil, like I said that before, so a little bit, not much, okay? That, see? Not much, okay? And salt. Now remember, we're going to go with the braised leeks over here. So, we don't want to do that. And a little paprika and a little herb. Oh, we talked about herbs. Herbages. There we go. Fresh herbs. Okay. We'll go here. Now, if you put the zest in there now, it's going to burn because you want to sear it. So we're not going to do that yet. Okay, we're going to get a pair of tongs right here, mix it up, and then put our fish in there. Now remember we talked about not pre-seasoning. We're seasoning it and we're cooking it within a couple of minutes. So we're okay. Okay. Roll the nice flavor on each side. Again, this is all low. All the low. Okay. Now we're going to take the pan here. Our front pan, we're going to put it on medium, medium high. Okay. Cooking here. The rice is cooking. You can see that here. Here we go. Look at that, huh? Okay. Here we go. We're going to shut that off because that's going to, that area we're cooking, we'll cook that nice. And a little bit of butter onto the bottom of this. And we're going to caramelize the carrots just at the beginning. And then we're going to add some chicken stock, too. Okay? That's what we talked about before. Okay? So, we've got a little bit of that here. Carrots have sugar in them, so that's why we can use it for caramelization. But you can't caramelize your snow peas because there's no sugar in them, okay? But your carrots you can do. Okay? Now, what we're going to do is we're going to make a little bit of a fortified butter. All fortified butter is oil of some sort with the butter. That raises the temperature. You're not going to burn the butter. You'll still burn the butter, but you'll take a long list. You'll be able to control it better. Okay, we'll take our carrots in there. See those carrots? Okay. Hear that, right? You're hearing that? Yeah. That's what we want. Okay, we're going to get them nice and brown. Our pan is cooking for our swordfish here. Okay, here's our leeks right there. Everything in the sink for the wife to clean later. You know, the wife is knackling, acting up behind me. She's laughing at me, but she knows. That's the key, that's the fun part. Let the kids clean with you, so they're not left out. They need to understand that cleaning is part of the cooking process. Okay, trash in here, here we go. Wash our hands again. All right. Okay, now, this is good. Everything's cooked, so you need to pay attention. You've got to pay attention. So if you have kids in the kitchen, or you've got distractions, keep your eye on everything. Okay? Here we go, okay? I'm going to turn up the heat just a little bit. Carrots start to not burn, but they're going to turn down. They will. And give us a little bit of flavor. Okay? Okay, we're going to hold off on that, on our swordfish right now. We have garlic here. You put the garlic in with the carrots, it's going to burn. So what we're going to do is we're going to wait. Just before we put the green onions and the soap peas in there, we're going to put the garlic in there. All right. A little bit of this chicken stock is in this jar. We're not going to use much of it. So you pay for it all, you use it all. Okay? There we go. Okay, I'm going to turn this up because I want it brown. That'll do. We're working at the carrots there, they need to get wrapped. Okay? So we're working on that. Okay? Okay, add a little salt to that. Salt is going to bring out the moisture like we talked about. And that's going to help caramelize. Okay, now keep in mind, you're cooking for two. You don't have to do a lot. But, okay. Hear it. Okay? Who should say? should sing better than I do. Better than yourself. And now, if you look close, okay, you see in there, it's turning down. It's caramelizing a little bit at a time. Okay, we're putting our pancake in here. It's getting warm. Okay? Now, it's not, this is not a non-stick. We have to use a little bit of oil. Again, what oil are we going to use? Olive oil. Why are we using olive oil? Does it mash up? Because it's good. I like olive oil. It works. Okay? Now, this is the point where everything just goes fast. Okay? You got your butter, we need to put away. Okay? Here. Yeah. Okay. Okay. See, now everything's kind of, see that? Look at that. We got some nice color. The fish is smoking. That's what we want. Listen now. That's what we want. We want to hear it. We want to hear that. Okay? We hear that, right? Now we got our carrots in there cooking. Okay? Now we're going to put our garlic in there really quick.
Swordfish, like we said,
3-4 minutes on each side. Within 8 minutes, it should be done. If you got a timer in front of you like I do, then you're okay. Okay? We'll get 2 plates. We'll show you what it's going to look like. Again, this is my kitchen, so it's not a studio. Eventually, we'll have that studio that we all want. So, you work with what you've got. Here we are. Okay, we're going to cut. We're going to shut our stove off. We're going to shut our swordfish off. Okay? Here we got our rice. So, we're going to serve our rice first. That's going to go in the bottom. And it's white. It does not have color. Why do we put color? Well, because we, like we said, we're going to do a basic rice. That's what we want. We've got color on the plate here. Okay? Rice. Kind of at, let's say, 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Okay? We need a spoon to serve our carrots and peas. Okay, now see that? Thanks. You get some color. Okay. Simple. And then our last thing is our swordfish. Okay. Swordfish here. Now, I have the skin on it. You don't want to serve the skin? Don't serve the skin. How do you tell if the fish is cooked? The skin comes off, the fish is cooked. Okay? Okay? Get yourself a fork. Okay? Find the skin. And then just roll it. Okay? The skin comes off. There we are. The skin comes off. We know it's cooked. Okay? So there we go.
See you next time at Simply Tasteful Dining. This is Chef Joe saying bon appetit. Thank you.